An empty tomb, the case for Easter. Good morning. A very happy Easter to all of you today. He is risen. He is risen indeed. Christ is risen. Christ is risen indeed. Just like any supernatural miracles baffle any rational mind of the postmodern world, the first century Christians were baffled by what they called the resurrection, an empty tomb. And the name of Christ changed everything. It created and continued to create history. Their struggle to understand it brought about astonishing accomplishment for their faith. Until Constantine the Great accepted Christianity as the religion of the state, it were difficult for them to profess, accept, and practice Christian faith legally. The question often asked, is it Christ who showed him the first two letters of Christ's name, Christos, in Greek language, so that Constantine and his army may win the battle of Melvian Bridge? Maxentius, drawn to the Tiber River during the battle, and he was killed, ending the tetrarch, and later his body was taken from the river and decapitated, and his head was paraded through the street of Rome on the day following the battle. Because of Christ, because of an empty tomb, we are even fighting today the battle that already won. Today we are going to meditate on Matthew's account of resurrection or Easter this morning. For Matthew, the gospel writer narrates the story of Christ with its unequivocal, ambiguous importance to the incarnation, the transfiguration, and finally the resurrection. The pedagogical twist of the story is that Matthew preferred telling the greatest story ever told to the human history from the perspective of the weakest link, the testimony or the witness from the perspective of the woman. If it was a cooked up story from the frightened disciples, they will put together some trustable story tale or trustable eyewitnesses in place. And I'm sure if you take it to the Jewish legal court, the story will not get its strength and validity. Mary Magdalene and the other Mary are going to see the tomb. We even do not know who this other Mary is. It might be an old gospel writer's way to refer Jesus' mother. Let not overlook the excitement or the urgency of the story by its background noise, like the earthquakes, angels rolling stones, frightened Roman soldiers, and empty graves. First Easter exploded with fear, excitement, and energy. For some, the story is full of fear and silence, even for some gospel writers. Fear is not the message for this morning from the empty tomb. Fear not, not because everything may go well, because God is in control and willing to do the supernatural. The power will not come from an outside source, rather from the inside source. What is inside the rock? The one who is buried inside the rock, rocky tomb, is the one who created the world, the one who hung the stars in the sky, the one who meticulously designed human DNA. Whatever day may hold, God has the power to face. We do not face it alone. Nothing we encounter is stronger or greater than God's unconditional love, and God's love always triumphs. There is no greater hope than Easter. Our world is under attack by a ruthless, unseen enemy. An enemy that does not come from God. It is the job of every Christian and every church, every ordinary radicals in Jesus' name to join in the Christian unity, to wage a spiritual warfare against this destructive evil until we defeat it. Right in front of our eyes, the Christian church in the world become an underground entity. Friends, the weapons of this warfare are not of this world. They are mighty through God. An enemy come to steal, kill, and destroy. But Christ said, I have come to give you life and life in abundance. If anyone has the authority in the world to speak, fear not, and I am sure it is the one who is victorious over death. If anyone in the universe has the power to tell, fear not, it is the empty tomb. According to Apostle Paul, our struggle is not against flesh and blood, but against the rulers and against the authorities, against the power of this dark world, and against the spiritual forces of evil in the heavenly realm. Let me tell you, my friends, we are fighting a war that is already won. This tragic pandemic called COVID-19 is an opportunity for the followers of Christ around the globe to unite and engage in spiritual warfare that will defeat the desires and the work of darkness. Just like the frightened, scattered disciples, the currently bunkered down Christians fighting against the unseen enemy, we are called to be in the spiritual battle. People searching for solutions, seeking for answers in this fear and anxiety-stricken world. Dear friends and family, do you know that Earth's saddest day and gladdest days were just 3 days apart? Resurrection defies the gravity of the old nature and restores the new nature. Easter is probably my favorite holidays because of the significance it holds for me as a Christian. It is the day the world remembers the rising of the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. It is the day Christ triumphed over the grave and sin. It gave me meaning to our life. Without the rising of the grave, all the rest of the things that we could do are meaningless. The empty tomb changed everything. The first Easter changed everything. Friedrich Nietzsche, a German philosopher, popularized the concept called God is dead and used the word figuratively to express the idea that God is dead, and during the Enlightenment period, Enlightenment killed the possibility of belief in God and any possibility to believe the existence of God. He had a great profound influence on Western philosophy and modern intellectual history. But Nietzsche, a German philosopher, died on 25th August 1900 at the age of 55 after battling with his forbidden condition for over 10 years. It is not the same if we ask the so-called intellectuals of the postmodern world. They could silently say religion is dead, God is dead, the church is dead. There is no scope for faith as radical followers of Christ. But let me tell you, my friends, it is not over yet. The story, the book is not closed. It is not over because of the empty tomb. You and I have hope. It is not over yet. C.S. Lewis once said, I believe in Christianity as I believe that the sun has risen. Not only because I see it, but because I see it. Because by it I see everything else. Today we celebrate the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ. The empty tomb changed everything. The resurrection of Christ is inseparable from the gospel of Christ and the message of the church. Resurrection gives meaning to the cross and meaning to our own suffering. Resurrection gives us meaning for Good Friday, the originator of a new religion came to the French diplomat Charles Maurice de Talleyrand and complained that he could not make any new converts to his newly formed religion. "What could you suggest I do?" he asked. "Recommend," said Charles Maurice, "that you get yourself crucified and then die, but be sure to rise again on the third day." The good news is that Jesus died and rose again. And because of this, we know that there is truly life beyond the grave. Everyone else is still dead. Aristotle, Confucius, Socrates, Plato, Karl Marx, Gandhi, Muhammad, Buddha, they are all dead, and their followers do not claim that they rose from the dead. They all go to venerate their tomb. The same applies to the philosophers and the modern leaders of enlightenment. Tradition says Muhammad died in AD 632, and guess what? He is still dead. Christians have no tomb to venerate or any such pilgrimage to make. Christians believe that their founder is alive and still in charge of everything. Jesus is the only one who lives forever to care for your soul, spirit, and body. Resurrection or Easter is the foundation and the culmination of the good news. Sunday morning, the stone was found, rolled away, and the body was transformed into a resurrected state. The grave clothes were still in place. If anyone tried to steal anything from the grave, it would be worth taking the 100 pounds of grave clothes. Can this group of disciples steal the body? You mean the doubting Thomas, the denied Peter, or other followers had the capacity to do that by overpowering the Roman guard and the religious leaders of the time? Did Christ's enemies steal the body? If Romans or the Jewish religious leaders had the body in their custody, surely they would have exposed it publicly, and Christianity could have died out. You may be a skeptic, but let me tell you that the brick wall of facts that points to one conclusion: Christ is risen. Friends, your life can be changed today. The whole trajectory of your life can be different. Maybe you have thought the game is over, that you have hit the dead end because of the mistakes you have made or the destructive habits you have caught in. The good news that it is not over yet. The more you think of Christ, Jesus is hidden. I can tell you stories after stories of Christ to reveal himself to the people, not only to the first century Jewish or Christian followers or the radicals, but even today, the postmodern radicals like us. Our Lord has written the promise of resurrection, not only in the books alone, but in every leaf of springtime, said Martin Luther. If Jesus was not resurrected, he could not differ from any other prophets, any other teachers, or any other philosophers, or any other faith traditions, and our faith and our message would be vain. Resurrection is the only source of power that transforms the heart. The cross is the demonstration of Christ's love. Resurrection is a demonstration of God's power. It is a fact that Jesus died on the cross, but it is a matter of faith that he rose from the dead. Jesus' resurrection established his kingdom and dominion over the kingdom of darkness. May the Lord help each and every one of us to celebrate the resurrection of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ today and every day. The tomb was empty on the first Easter morning, and the tomb is still empty today. God raised Jesus from the death to life, and he still lives among us today, just today as we speak. One of my favorite Easter hymn is that he lives. believes, which captures the essence of Easter best with its those words: I serve a risen Savior. He is in the world today. I know that He is living wherever, whatever force may say. I see His hand of mercy. I hear His voice of cheer. And just the time I need Him, He is always near. He leaves. Christ Jesus leaves today. He walks with me and talks with me along life's narrow way. He leaves. Salvation to impart. You ask me, no, I know He leaves. He lives within my heart. If you don't know Christ in a personal manner, let me invite you today to please repeat this prayer with me today. Dear Jesus, I am a skeptic. I'm a doubtful follower of Christ, lost with fear and anxiety. Help me to understand the meaning of resurrection. Come into my heart right now and give me life and life in abundance. Help me to receive your forgiveness and your freedom. Accept me as your son or as your daughter today, O Lord. Thank you for your peace. Thank you for your love. Thank you for the resurrection. Thank you for the empty tomb. You are my Lord, my Savior, and my shepherd. In Jesus' precious name we pray. Amen and amen. If you have prayed this prayer first time in your life, let us know that. Please send us a message, or please comment below the message, and we would like to love to connect with you in a personal manner. May the resurrection power of our Lord Jesus Christ, the everlasting love of the Father, and fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us today and every day. Amen and amen. Let's sing together, He Lives, He Lives Today.